नमस्कार दोस्तों, स्वागत है आप सभी का स्टडी आईक्यू में। आज हम लोग कर्नाटका से जुड़ी हुई एक चर्चा करने वाले। हाल ही में कर्नाटका में बाईपोल्स हुए थे दो असेंबली सीट्स के लिए। उन दो असेंबली सीट्स में एक बीजेपी जीत चुकी है, दूसरी कांग्रेस जीत चुकी है। तो हम लोग आज इस पॉलिटिकल सिनेरियो के ऊपर एक एनालिसिस करेंगे, क्योंकि 2023 में असेंबली इलेक्शंस आने वाले हैं कर्नाटका के। तो ये जो रिजल्ट्स है बाईपोल्स के, आर दे एन इंडिकेशन ऑफ 2023, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन 2023, इसके ऊपर हमारी चर्चा चलेगी और ये चर्चा होगी इंग्लिश में। सो व्हाट आर वी गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वी आर गोइंग टू एनालाइज द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ दीज बाईपोल्स एंड पोटेंशियली मेक अ फोरकास्ट ऑफ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू कम इन 2023 असेंबली इलेक्शंस इन कर्नाटका। दैट वुड बी द एजेंडा फॉर डिस्कशन। To get all this information, stay with me on Study IQ. I am your friend Rahul Saigaonkar. You can follow me on the ID @RahulSai222. And if you're preparing for PSC examinations like Karnataka PSC, we do have a course of Karnataka PSC. Just visit the details that are given here to know about our programs and avail our services. And this discussion is very important because we're going to talk about the political development. So you'll understand the political scenario, you'll understand about the bipoles and a potential forecast of 2023. Many a times in the state PSEs, we do get questions about the state politics also, right? Let's begin the discussion. Let's try to understand the news. As I told you, there were bipoles in Karnataka on two assembly seats, one in Hangal and one in Sindhi. Hangal comes in Haveri, Sindhi in Raichur district. We do know that, right? Now, what happened? It gave a mixed verdict. One seat was won by BJP and another seat was won by Congress. And the results came on November 2, 2021. The first thing that you need to remember is Hangal was a stronghold of BJP before. Now, the BJP has lost in Hangal. And in Sindhi, earlier, it was the JDS. The seat belonged to JDS. Here, JDS lost and BJP won this particular seat. So, this particular result has given some crucial insights into the standing of three main political parties in Karnataka. What are we going to see in 2023? We're going to make a forecast of that. Alright, so do know these facts, because before we go into the analysis part, we need to remember some facts about Karnataka. In Karnataka, there are three major parties which contest. There is BJP, of course, there is Indian National Congress, and there is a state party or the regional party, that is JDS, Janata Dal Secular, which is headed by H.D. Devegowda and his son H.D. Kumaraswamy. Alright, now, after this, we need to also remember something else. Because in recent times in Karnataka, there was a change in leadership. Earlier, the chief minister was B.S. Yediyurappa. He was changed a couple of months back, and now the chief minister of Karnataka is Basavaraj Bommai. And Basavaraj Bommai's home turf is Hangal, that is Haveri district itself. So it was being continuously looked at what would be the result of Hangal election, because in Hangal, the incumbent candidate CM Udasi, he expired and there was a bipolar election. In Sindhi also, the JDS candidate MC Manguli, he expired. So that is why there was a bipole. So we need to remember there was a change in leadership. Apart from that, we need to also remember about the national scenario. National scenario with respect to, I'd say, inflation. Inflation, the petrol and diesel prices were quite high. Did that play a role in these elections? We are going to also analyze that. Right. So by keeping all these facts in mind, let's try to see what exactly happened, because you'll get an idea. See, in Sindhi, the BJP's candidate Ramesh Bhusanur, he won by a huge margin, right? 31,000 vote margin. The second candidate was Ashok Managuli. The JDS, the regional party, it came a distant third with 4,353 votes. Now, in Hangal, which was a very interesting place, in Hangal, the Congress candidate Srinivas Mane, he defeated BJP's Shivraj Sajjanar by 7,000 odd votes in Hangal. Now, this was a surprise. Now, after this particular result, many people are telling that the Congress has become resurgent again in Karnataka. We'll try to analyze that. But please note that the JDS, the regional party, it garnered a mere 927 votes. In Sindhi, it garnered 4,000 odd votes. The candidate lost the deposit. In Hangal also, it got only 927 votes. The candidate lost the deposit. So what exactly happened? BJP, where it was being told that Hangal seat may be retained by BJP, they lost there. Congress won. Sindhi, BJP gave a surprise and they won here. Now, what do we have in future? From these elections, what can we forecast about the 2023 assembly election? Because we know that in 2023, the elections are going to be held in Karnataka. Let's try to analyze. Let's first talk about the BJP. See, we know that in BJP, the leadership was changed recently from Yediyurappa to Basavaraj Bommai. येडियुरप्पा इज अ वेरी टॉल लिंगायत लीडर फ्रॉम कर्नाटका. ही वॉज रिप्लेस्ड बाय बोम्मई. नाउ बोम्मई इज ऑल्सो अ लिंगायत लीडर, अल्बीट नॉट अ टॉल लीडर एज येडियुरप्पा आई वुड से. बट आफ्टर बसवराज बोम्मई बिकेम चीफ मिनिस्टर, एवरीबडी वॉज लुकिंग एट दीज पर्टिकुलर बाईपोल्स एज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ अ रेफरेंडम अबाउट द लीडरशिप चॉइस ऑफ बीजेपी. And the seat that BJP lost at Hangal was some sort of a referendum where Basavaraj Bommai lost the seat. I'd say under his leadership, the BJP lost the seat in Hangal where they had a stronghold. So this puts a big, big question mark over the future of Basavaraj Bommai as the leader. What we can expect now? Who will be the leader of BJP in 2023 assembly elections? Will it be Basavaraj Bommai? After these results, it's quite uncertain. Will Yediyurappa be back at the helm of BJP for 2023 elections? Again, quite unlikely, but Yediyurappa is already planning a statewide tour preparing for 2023 elections. Although he has not got a go-ahead from the BJP High Command. So the question remains, if not Yediyurappa, if not Basavaraj Bommai, then who? There are other leaders, other Lingayat leaders like Jagdish Shetta, there is Arvind Bella, there is Murugesh Nirani, who was dubbed as successor of Yediyurappa, but a surprise choice came out as Basavaraj Bommai. So the big question that is in front of us, who will lead BJP in the 2023 assembly elections? So as things unfurl, we'll talk about that again. But in a scenario where we see that there is no leader, no local leader under whose leadership the BJP is going to contest, then there is one alternative, that is Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Now the big question in front of everybody is that can Narendra Modi, with his image, with the Modi wave, can he win Karnataka assembly elections? According to Yediyurappa, it is unlikely. He says that riding only on the Modi wave or riding only on the leadership of Modi, BJP cannot win in Karnataka. He said that the local leadership, especially Lingayat community leaders at the local level, have to be developed. So it is going to be really interesting how the BJP is going to take these results. Will there be a change in leadership? Who will be the leader? Under whose patronage they'll contest election? This is to be seen. Now, apart from that, I spoke about inflation, about the petrol and diesel prices. Did this inflation, did petrol diesel prices play a huge role in these elections? I'd say perhaps no, since they were local elections, they did not play a big role. It needs to be analyzed further. But as we already know that the center has reduced the excise duties, the state has also reduced VAT. So the diesel has come by 17 rupees. The diesel has come down by 17 rupees in Karnataka, which might play a role potentially in future. But as of now, in these bipoles, I'd say the inflation, petrol, diesel prices have not played a huge role in terms of election results. So things are looking a little bleak for BJP in terms of leadership scenario. But things are quite bright for Indian National Congress, especially after they won the Hangal constituency. Hangal victory, it provided new momentum of Congress. It provides a new momentum to Congress. These were the news snippets. But again, if we look closely, I would say that this new momentum is rather temporary, because the political experts, they're suggesting that the Hangal victory was predominantly because of the work done by the candidate, Congress candidate Srinivas Mane. He helped immensely. He helped people immensely during the first wave of COVID-19, the second wave of COVID-19. And a lot of contribution of this victory, it goes to Srinivas Mane. But nonetheless, he did win on the Congress ticket. But now we can say that Congress has got some sort of momentum for sure. And if they scrape through certain issues that are already there in their party, then they will be a key player to watch in this election. We might also see a two-cornered contest, BJP versus Congress in Karnataka. Now, if you look at Congress, there are two things from leadership perspective we need to observe. One is at the national level. Now, at the national level, there are no prizes for guessing here. Who will be the leader of Congress? Will it be Rahul Gandhi? That is a question. And everybody in Karnataka are also keenly observing it. If you look at Congress party, in many states, it's already in shambles. We can talk about Punjab, we can talk about West Bengal, Assam. In many states, they are losing their clout. Will the same thing happen in Karnataka? That's a big question mark. And a lot depends on the national leadership. But you might argue that, sir, if we look at Congress in terms of state leadership, they're doing pretty sound, isn't it? The leadership, it is with Siddaramaiah. ही इज अ फॉर्मर चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ कर्नाटका. बट अगेन इफ यू लुक इन द स्टेट कांग्रेस ऑल्सो देर इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फैक्शनलिज्म ग्रोइंग इन स्टेट. The party has been divided into two factions. On one side, there is Siddaramaiah, but on the other side, there is DK Shi, there is DK Shiv Kumar. So two factions are in a power struggle. And if they scrape through these two issues, then they will be a big, big player to watch out in the state of Karnataka, in southern India. Right. Now, this was about the Congress. And what can we expect in future? A possible two-way contest between BJP and Congress. But the biggest loser in these bipoles has been the JDS. It's tensions for HD Devegowda and HD Kumaraswamy. Why? Because in Karnataka bipoles, JDS lost the plot, their candidates lost the deposit. They got very few votes. It was quite surprising because Sindhgi was held by them. JDS candidate Managuli was the Sindhgi MLA, but this time they lost. And in both the places, they are third. Congress has been a benefactor. They have been in one seat, they have won, and in the other seat, they have a second spot, which is a positive for them. But for JDS, it's a big question mark. Why they lost the plot? They lost the plot because of the candidates they chose. At both the seats, JDS chose Muslim candidates. They gave tickets to Muslim candidates. Now, this was clearly a ploy to garner the minority votes. But it backfired immensely, and it gave a lot of advantage to Congress because Congress continuously ran a campaign suggesting that JDS is the Team B of BJP. And this particular campaign, I'd say it connected with the voters also. Because in both the constituencies, Sindhgi and Hangul, minority votes, they did go en masse to Congress where they saw victory in one of the seats. So what is the potential future of JDS? If we look at 2023, JDS will still be, I would say, a minority player in Karnataka. Especially what they can look for is a target of around 40 seats, predominantly from southern Karnataka. If you look at the stronghold of JDS, you will find it in southern side of Karnataka, in Mandya, Mysore, Chamarajnagar. But they have a very small presence in North Karnataka. So if they are looking potentially towards this number of seats, then they'll again play a role of kingmaker. So JDS will remain marginalized, but it needs to be seen that in 2023, will they be able to get to this number and become a kingmaker again? So what are we heading at in Karnataka? A three-cornered contest where JDS is being marginalized right now. It is being dubbed as a Team B of BJP. A possible two-way contest is also there, BJP versus the Congress. So look out for Karnataka elections in 2023. We'll keep an eye on that. And if there is any development, we'll talk about that as soon as possible on Study IQ. That is it from my side in this part of lecture. Thank you for watching this. Jai Hind.